Welcome to this brief guide on using gems in Google Workspace. If you've been using Gemini and its custom gems, you probably know the drill. You have your Google Doc or Sheet open in one tab and the Gemini web app open in another. You work on your content, then you have to select it, copy it, switch tabs, paste it into your favorite gem, and then copy the result back over. It's powerful, but it's a bit of a juggle, right? Well, I've got some fantastic news. That entire workflow, the constant switching and the copy-paste dance, is now a thing of the past. Gems are now available directly inside the Google Workspace side panel. And the best part? This isn't just for premium business accounts. It's now rolling out to all users. So whether you have a paid business workspace plan or you're just using a standard free personal Gmail account, you now have the capacity to use Gems right inside your apps. This is an absolute game changer. The biggest benefit is that you no longer need to leave your document in order to use them. They can access the context of your work directly, saving you a massive amount of time. Now, if you've never built a gem before, don't worry. I have an entire video dedicated to showing you how, step by step, and I'll have that linked in the description below. For now, let's dive in and see this new integrated workflow in action. All right, here we are in a Google Doc. For this first example, I want to show you something that I do several times a week. I've just finished a meeting and I've typed up all of my notes for our Project Nova marketing sync. As you can see, if I scroll through, the notes are fairly detailed. We've got the agenda, discussion points, some key decisions that were made, and a list of action items at the bottom. Now, this document is great for my own records, but it's far too long to just paste into an email or a Slack channel to update the rest of the team. My task is to pull out the most important information, so the decisions and the action items, and put it into a concise summary. In the past, this meant carefully rereading everything and manually typing out a new, shorter version. But today, we're going to do it in seconds. So the first thing I need to do is to bring up my AI assistant. To do that, I'll move my cursor up to the top right corner of the screen to this little icon here. This is the Ask Gemini button, and clicking it is our gateway to using Gems inside Google Workspace. Now, with the side panel open, you can see a list of some of my available Gems. The one I want is a custom gem that I built specifically for this task called Meeting Summarizer. I created this because I do it so often, and I've preloaded it with instructions on exactly how I like my summaries to be formatted, which saves me even more time. I'll select it now. The real magic here, and the core reason this integration is so powerful, is that this gem is now context aware. That means that it can read and understand the document that I have open right here. I don't need to copy and paste anything. I just need to tell it how to process the information it already sees. So here in the prompt box, I'm going to give it a clear instruction. I'll type, using the context of this document, generate a summary. The summary should include three sections: key decisions, a summary of action items with who they are assigned to, and a brief overview of the discussion. I'm being specific here because a good prompt always leads to a great result. I've defined the exact structure that I want. Now, I'll hit enter and we'll watch it work. And there we have it. In just a few seconds, it's done. Let's take a look at how it did. It's created the three sections that I asked for. Under key decisions, it's correctly pulled out that we're doubling down on video content and focusing on the momentum campaign. If we look back at the main document, you can see that it's identified those points perfectly from my notes. Now for the action items. This is fantastic. It's not only pulled the items, but it has also correctly assigned them. Ben to draft the case study, Chloe to contact customers, Sarah to formalize the brief, and David to provide the assets. It understood the relationship between the task and the person assigned. This is exactly what I needed, and it's perfectly formatted. All that's left for me to do is to click this little copy button right here, and I can switch over to my email or Slack and paste this in. A task that used to take me 10 or 15 minutes of careful rereading and typing is now, quite literally, done in seconds. Okay, now that was awesome, but we're not just limited to working with text in Google Docs. Let's switch gears and head over to Google Sheets for a more technical but incredibly powerful example. Here I have my automated Slack message sender sheet. As you can see, I've set it up with a clear structure. I have columns for the specific message content that I want to post. I have the corresponding Slack channel ID for where it should go, the exact scheduled post time and time zone. And finally, there's a status column, which I'll use to track whether the message is pending or has been successfully sent. The goal here is to connect all of this data and have the sheet automatically post the right message to the right channel at the right time, updating its status as it goes. The only way to achieve this kind of custom automation is with a bit of code using a tool called Google Apps Script. Google Apps Script is the powerful scripting language that's built right into Google's applications, allowing you to make them do almost anything. Now, while I have some experience with it, I want to make sure I start this project on the right foot. So I'm going to use a gem as my expert coding partner. Just like in Docs, the Ask Gemini button is waiting for me in the top right. I'll click it to open the side panel. This time though, instead of my custom summarizer, I'm going to select the Google Apps Script Assistant gem. This is a gem that is specifically trained to understand and help with coding questions related to Google's ecosystem. Now, my goal here isn't to get the gem to write all of the code for me in one go. Instead, I want to use it as an expert partner. I'll start with a high-level question to validate my idea and to get a clear roadmap of the steps involved. It's like asking a senior developer, is what I'm trying to do a good idea, and where should I begin? So I'll type my question in plain English. I've got this sheet, and what I'm trying to do is basically automate the sending of Slack messages using Google Apps Script. Is this possible, and what are the main steps I would need to take? Okay, let's break down the kind of response we can expect here, because it's always incredibly helpful. First, it will almost certainly give me clear information. A yes, this is possible, which, let's be real, is a great confidence boost. Next, it will typically lay out a high-level roadmap for me. It'll mention the key components that I need to work with. For instance, it's going to explain how Slack allows external apps to connect, usually through a special URL that's often referred to as a webhook. It's going to identify this as a necessary first step. Then, it's going to describe the core logic for this project. I'll need to write a centralized function within Google Apps Script. It then describes how that function's job is to read the data from the rows in my sheet, the message from column A, the channel from this variable over here, and then package it all up to be sent. And crucially, it points me towards the automation mechanism. It'll talk about something called a time-driven trigger, which is a feature in Apps Script that allows me to run my code automatically on a schedule. Finally, what's really helpful is that it will almost always provide a starter code snippet. Now, this won't be the final complete solution by any stretch, but it will be a great block of code that gives me a fantastic foundation on which to build. It handles the basic structure and boilerplate, so I can focus on plugging in the specifics from my sheet. This guidance is just invaluable, and it takes a daunting project and makes it approachable. And for those of you whose interest has been sparked by this and you want to really dive deep into what Google Apps Script can do, from the absolute basics all the way to more advanced techniques like this, I've created a full-length, detailed video on just that topic. It's the perfect next step to take after seeing a powerful example like this, and I'll make sure it's linked in the description below. So there you have it. Two completely different apps, two very different problems, both made incredibly simple with the help of a well-instructed gem right here in the side panel. We've seen how you can turn pages of notes into a perfect summary and how you can get expert guidance to start a complex coding project without ever leaving your workflow. The real power here, though, is customization. So take the time to experiment. Think about your most repetitive tasks and start building your own gems to help you with those tasks. Again, check out my video on creating gems if you want a bit of a guide. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments below what kind of gems you plan on building yourself, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.